Girl. Yes, you. In the right place. Stick around because we are going to be talking about some Christian girl essentials. Hey, what's going on? It's your girl, Brittany. And yes, finally, first video finally out. Here I am, and we are going to be talking about something I'm so enthusiastic and excited to talk about. Something that I wish I had when I was first starting my walk, which are some essentials every single Christian girl should have. Now, I want to preface this video by saying not everything in this video you need to have to continue your walk with God. But I will say that these items that I'm going to list were pretty essential in my own walk and, you know, definitely aided in me progressing. Again, not saying you need to have these things, but they definitely helped. So why don't we just get into this video real quick? And before you go, I'm gonna be announcing a giveaway at the end of this video, so stay tuned. So first things first, you want a Bible, okay? Now, I'm crazy and I have like 3,200 like different Bibles, but these are the three main Bibles that I love to use. So these two I recently got, but this one I've had for, it's been a trooper for about a minute now. So this one I have here is my New Living Translation Life Application Study Bible, and I absolutely love it. And I think that number one for sure, girl, get yourself a study Bible. A study Bible is so good because it can give you commentary and insight on scripture that you deeply want to study. It can do word studies for you. It can give you, you know, dictionaries, concordances, maps, charts, timelines, so many things that can give you context for what you're reading instead of just, you know, I don't know, like reading something and like Genesis and you have no idea like what the heck even Mesopotamia is. But the point I'm trying to say is that you want something that's going to give you context and deepen your understanding of the word. So a study Bible, a basic study Bible, is so good for that. I personally love the life application study Bible. Because it's just so easy to navigate through, and it has commentary all at the bottom. I'm just gonna put a shot of it right here. It has commentary all throughout the bottom, and it's just so, so great. Another study Bible that I really love, like since I've gotten it, girl, Systematic Theology Study Bible, ESV. Now, not a lot of people are a fan of studying all that stuff, theology, like what the heck is even it? But I'm telling you that this will play a humongous role in growing your faith and helping you to understand what are the major themes of scripture. You know, what is the purpose of God saying this here and that here? Why did he, you know, write this in this way through this person? And I think theology definitely helps with that. And the way that systematic theology is woven into the study Bible, oh my gosh, like you will deepen your knowledge so fast. You will be studying and not even recognize the depth of knowledge that you're taking in until it comes time to, of course, synthesize it and see how it applies in your life. You're like, I didn't know I was taking this in while I was reading. And it's really, really great for that. Gives commentary in the same kind of way as most study Bibles. And again, the word studies, concordances, a lot of great stuff is in the study Bible. Now for my girls who love to be artsy and creative and love to journal, I am going to recommend for you this awesome Bible. It looks so tiny in my hands right now, but I can tell you this right now, it is extremely heavy. So this is called the Illustrating Bible. And I'm recommending this Bible because sometimes, you know, you want to break from all the commentaries. You want to break from all the additional words. And I mean, use your resources as you need to as you're going into the text. However, you want a Bible that's just going to be just quiet, just you and God and the Holy Spirit just speaking to you as you are reading. Again, use resources as you need to. But I'm saying that sometimes you just want that quietness, and I'm going to put a shot of it here as I flip through some of my notes. It's just really, really great for you to just use for your quiet time specifically, and so that you can just get into the Word and just get to know God on a deeper level than just studying it, you know, academically, because sometimes we can get a bit too rigid and study academically the word, but sometimes, you know, you really just want to remember, one, it's a spiritual practice as well as academic, and you can't get away from that. And so if you're looking to also deepen that quiet time, that personal time with the Lord, I would also recommend a journaling Bible. Now, if you have a journaling Bible, that is awesome, because you have two things in one. You're able to write along with the text, and I'm not saying you can't write in your study Bible, but you know, a journaling Bible is intentionally made so that you can write alongside the text, but not all Bibles are made that way. And so if you have a journaling Bible, that's great. Like, sis, you are on your way to getting to know the Word even more. But for my sisters who may just have a study Bible or even just a regular Bible, what you want to do is have a journal, okay? These are a couple journals that I've worked through. These are kind of crusty, but I love, love, love journaling. Not everybody likes journaling, and what I mean by journaling is not like, you know, like dear journal, all this stuff, like, or scrapbooking or anything like that. You can if you want to, but what I mean by journaling is you take time to take what you read in the text and studied and write it down so that you can synthesize the information that you took in. Because it's one thing to read the word, and then it's another thing to actually understand what it's saying. And so you never want to be in a predicament where, you know, you read a text and, you know, you kind of just take it for what it is and you just say, yep, that's it. What did you read? I read exactly this. And you repeat what the verse you read said. And, you know, you can't really formulate it in your own words. And that's the beauty of journaling, is because it gives you the ability to do that. It gives you the ability to write things in your own words. And it's just so, so awesome. So I would recommend just getting a little notebook. It doesn't even have to be anything crazy or cutesy. Like, I have this little crusty thing here, but, you know, I just have a couple notes that I've just dated and just used to really just gauge my understanding of the text. And, you know, I also believe that alongside the studying Bible or even journaling Bible, when you journal, it helps you to be more inquisitive of the text. And what do I mean by that? I mean that it helps you to critically think about what the text is saying, again, leading you to being able to understand what it says. So, of course, if you're going to journal, girl, if you're going to journal, you're going to want some writing tools. So, this is what we got going on right here, all right? So I have the Sakura Jelly Roll pens recommended to me by a friend. I absolutely love these pens. They write so smoothly. Midliner highlighters, of course. You want highlighters, you want pens. You know, whatever is going to engage you with your writing. Some people like it plain and some people like it colorful, like me. So I like to get creative, I like to get colorful. So I use these awesome mid-liner highlighters along with the Jelly Roll pens. Sometimes I'll use the Bible High Glider. It's a highlighter, but it's like a gel highlighter. It's really, really cool, doesn't bleed through the paper, and it's just so easy to use, alongside the Sakura Micron pens. And these pens are really cool because they come in three different pen sizes, and maybe I'll write it out so you guys can see how they write. They are just so awesome for journaling. They're so awesome for you know, just writing in your Bible or in your journal. And so of course when you do that, you of course get even more engaged with the text. Like, it becomes much more fun, I would say, than again just sitting and just be like, oh, I have to read this today. Like, no, like, I'm gonna spend time with my Father in His Word, getting to know Him, and I can be creative as I do it. All these things are so, so, so great because, again, it helps you to know who God is. So in addition to having the Word and, you know, having a study Bible or, you know, having a journal to synthesize the information that you take in, another great tool that you can use are books. And what I mean by books, like outside resources, people who tell you how to navigate through the Word, how to apply it into your life in a practical way as well. So this is Women of the Word by Jen Wilkin and A Holy Pursuit by Diane Jago. Both touch on two different areas of the faith. One, how to actually navigate your Bible and how to read it. And two, how to actually carry your cross daily and not give into worldly thinking, but to follow God's will. And so these books, of course, show you how to apply God's word in your life. And so one, it's one thing to read the word. Two, it's another thing to understand it. And three, it's another thing to apply it and live it out. And so these books help you to apply and live it out, of course. Another thing that is also really, really awesome are devotional books. And so I love devotional books, and I'm just going to show real quick the devotional book that I have. It's called Good Morning, Lord. Can we talk? I don't know, it's a little bit corny, but I love this book because every single morning I can read it, I can open it up, and it's just a seed planted in my heart for me to meditate on God's word and for me to eventually open up my Bible. And so this book is just so great. I've had it probably for about like almost 2 years now, I would say. And I absolutely, absolutely love it. So I would recommend getting a devotional book. And hey, if you don't have a devotional book, you can do something really creative at home as well. All you need is just a glass container, a container in general, really, and some paper. And so I'm just gonna show you guys real quick what I think. So this is what you call a prayer jar. So my prayer jar is just pretty simple, just crumpled up pieces of paper. But these crumpled up pieces of paper are pretty special because they have scripture on them. So I will just take out a random one for the day. Like, let's just say I just take this one out. And what does it say on it? I love you, Lord. You are my strength. And this is from Psalm 18, verse 1. And so I wake up in the morning or even before I go to bed and I take this scripture out and I'm thinking about it for the day, about how much I love God and how He is my strength. And I pray about that in the morning and before I go to bed. And so prayer jars are just so simple and so easy that you can do. And they just like enable you to just meditate on who God is. It's nothing even extensive or crazy. Like, it doesn't ask you to open up your whole Bible and read like 40 chapters of a book, but it just simply says, this is who God is. Think about it, pray on it, meditate on it. Don't forget who He is. Sometimes we may think that, you know, the walk is very black and white. And what I mean by that is like studying is very black and white. It's very boring. And not a lot of people like to do that. I mean, I don't like to study even my regular academics. So, you know, I can't even really chat, but knowing who God is in through devotional books, maybe through some practical books that tell you how to apply the word, maybe through journaling, maybe through a study Bible, maybe through a systematic theology study Bible. All those things make God just more tangible, I feel like. And what I mean by that is like easier to understand, easier to grasp, and just really understand in our feeble minds. I mean, even those things don't even just scratch the surface of who He is. But it helps you to be more engaged and get to know who He is more. So I pray that these couple of tips and essentials, you know, helped in some form or fashion. Of course, I'm gonna reiterate this again. Sorry, I keep looking over here because I see myself. I know y'all are over there, but I keep looking over here. I know that I mentioned all these things, but remember that all you really need is, first, one, to be willing to be, spoken to by God, to listen, willing to listen to Him as you're reading a Bible, maybe a journal and a pen, and you are really good to go. That's really all it takes to study God's word. But these things in particular have helped me to deepen my walk, helped me to be more consistent. So girl, I'm not just throwing these things your way. This is my testimony. About how God has allowed these things to be a part of my life now and a part of my study time and my quiet time. And so I pray that it'll do the same for you. But before I let you go, there is like a giveaway that I gotta talk about. So let's get the moment we've been waiting for. Giveaway time. Hey, giveaway time. We're gonna talk about a giveaway. In light of like everything that's just happening right now in our world, I thought that it would be just so timely for us to do a giveaway on prayer. So I'm gonna be giving away a prayer kit. And now this prayer kit is designed for people who may not feel that close to God, may feel as though their prayer life isn't all that strong, may feel like God doesn't hear them when they pray. And so this prayer kit is to enable you to pray, to enable you to deepen your relationship with God, just by simply talking to Him. And so what's included in this prayer kit are a few awesome things. So what's gonna happen, y'all, is we're gonna have four winners, okay? We're gonna have four different winners. The main winner is going to win a prayer jar, which I'm gonna show right here. So they're gonna be able to win this beautiful prayer jar. One of these will be theirs, as well as the Sakura Jelly Roll pens that I mentioned earlier. They're also going to be able to win the Valley of Vision Puritan prayer and devotional book. These are really awesome, y'all. A practical book on a praying life that tells you how to pray, you know, in a distracting world. It's by Paul E. Miller. It's a really, really good book, and I'm really excited to give it away, as well as a $5 Amazon gift card. And of course, you know, your girl gotta hook you up with a journal. So a prayer journal, really, to write down, you know, your prayer requests to God. Who are you praying for, and has God answered those prayers? And, you know, just to use it as a tool to talk to Him. And so I do pray that this giveaway will excite you a little bit. And I'm going to be posting really all of the details on how to enter in on my IG page. So if you haven't, go follow me at Brittany Borghella. Go check me out. And of course, like, subscribe to this YouTube channel, because, like, don't you want updates? Like, don't you want more, like, content? Like, so go ahead, like this video, share it with a friend if you know somebody who may be struggling with prayer and would be interested in this prayer kit. Before I let you go, do you mind if I pray with you real quick, actually? Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for the person who is on the other side of this screen, my God. You know their needs, you know their heart, my God, and so I pray that you will put a peace and a calmness in their heart at this time, my God. I pray that as they go about their days, Lord God, that you would just continue to just draw them nearer to you, draw them nearer to your word. My God, would you strengthen them in their walk with you? Would you strengthen them in their knowledge and understanding of who you are and what your word says? I pray, Father, that you would help them to apply it in their life and to live it out. I thank you for them, and I thank you for allowing us to have this time to talk, and pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. I love you guys, and I hope to see a lot of entries soon. Bye.